Let's pray. Father God, thank you so much for this glorious day that you brought us, the beautiful Colorado sunshine, welcoming the guests here from California. And we just thank you so much for what you're bringing in today. We ask just for a prayer of protection over this marriage that is beginning today, and that your love would be foundational as they move forward. Bless this time in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. Except for you guys. Hold on a second. Today we come together to witness the uniting of Samuel and Destiny. Just as we ready ourselves to celebrate the gift of God's love coming down to bring peace to this earth, today brings promises of a new future bathed in love for these two. In many ways, this is a day of beginnings, the beginning of a marriage, a partnership in love, a journey of togetherness. But more than a beginning, today is simply the turning of a page in a great story, a story we are all a part of, whether we are aware of this or not. We read the beginning of the story in Genesis. God created the heavens, the earth, the light, the dark, waters, sky, and then all living things, wild animals, livestock, winged creatures, and all these things he called good. Then, in his own image, he created man, male and female, which he called very good. We read that man and woman were not created at the same time. However, man was first created out of the dust of the earth. God saw that even with the animals to keep him company, even having the ability to walk hand in hand with his creator, it was not good for man to be alone. So out of Adam's own flesh, God created woman. And it is said in Genesis, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh." So in that same tradition, who gives this woman to become one flesh with this man? I'm going to take a little privilege here, and I get to have the first selfie with the couple. Okay, so big smiles. Okay, perfect. All right. That's the benefit of getting to do this. Okay, Samuel and Destiny. And you guys can look at each other, you can look at me, you can get lost in his eyes, whatever you'd like. Okay? You've made it clear that your love will be built on a firm foundation. A foundation in which God has laid out for us. This foundation is strong, and as the two of you journey through life, the foundational love of God will make your love for each other all the stronger. There are many passages about God's love in his word. Two of them, however, speak majors to the love, to what love is and the strength that it carries. The first passage in 1 Corinthians 13 reads, "Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres, and love never fails." This is a type of love that must drive your relationship. It is a love that is full of humble servitude and great strength. It describes the foundational love of God, and today you make the promise that this is how you will spend the rest of your lives loving each other. And in this love, you will each have roles, but always remember that today you join each other as one flesh. Living this love will not always be easy. There will be times when it seems easier to walk away. It is in these times that you must fervently press on, trusting that God will carry you through, relying on his foundation. After all, he is the author of love. In fact, God is love. It is through God that we learn how to love, as he showed us the greatest of all, love of all when he sent his son to lay his life down so that we may become one with him. In that same way, the two of you are becoming one, and yet you are still two. And we read our second passage about love from Ecclesiastes 4:9-12. Two are better than one, because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not easily broken. Samuel and Destiny, together, the two of you will be stronger. You will be there to serve each other, to protect each other, and to hold each other. And yet there is a third part, and that third is God. Together, the two of you will stand strong, and with God, you will not be broken. John 15:12, Jesus tells his disciples, "My command is this, love each other as I have loved you." As you journey together through life, follow this command, and love each other just as Jesus has loved you. Put the other first, be willing to be wrong, sacrifice your pride that your spouse would know your love. Destiny, as you step into wifehood, respect your husband, seek to understand him, support him. Be willing to give up your desires that he may reach his. And Samuel, as a husband, it will be your duty to lead your wife, not through authority, but through love. Not by ruling over her, but by caring for her, providing for her, being willing to give up your desires that she may reach hers. What the two of you will find is that while as you give up your personal desires, those desires will actually be met through the bond of love. Together, you will chase your dreams, and you will find full support from each other as you do so. Throw in all the cards and love with no abandon, and you will accomplish more than you could ever imagine. And now, family and friends, a charge to you. Samuel and Destiny will need your help. They will need you to love them, to support them, to counsel them, and to encourage them, and most powerfully, to pray for them. Those of us who are married know it's not always a honeymoon phase, and they need us to be there in their good times and their bad. We are told to love our neighbors as we love ourselves, and I can think of no better way to love our neighbors than to support and encourage them in their marriages. So before we finalize their covenant of marriage through their vows, let us first, as their friends and family, make a covenant with them. If you would repeat after me. We commit to love Samuel and Destiny through their marriage. We acknowledge that we are a part of their story. And commit to encourage and support them. In their times of comfort and stress, sickness and health, poorness and in wealth, we will lift them up in the broken places and will celebrate them in their joy. We will walk with them on this great journey of life. So you guys have all of us behind your backs here and the greatest foundation of God's love. Sam and Destiny, you're about to give your vows. These vows you're about to make are to each other and to God and should not be taken lightly. So let us pray this marriage prayer. Father God, all that we have came only from you. Everything we hope for came only from your love. All that we enjoy, you gave us freely. Everything we ask is only yours to give. Father, give us the light to understand, put fire behind our will, and be at the beginning of all we begin. Excite this love and strengthen the weakness. Encompass their desires. Father, shield their thoughts and cradle their bodies. And as we breathe this prayer in our hearts, may we feel your presence. Amen. So Samuel and Destiny have chosen to write their own vows. And so at this time, Samuel, would you give your vows? Do you need that? You want that? I didn't know if you had them memorized.
My sweetest Destiny, it was only a sprinkle of love, a pinch of time, and a dash of 2020 before always and forever would become a reality for us. From day one, you have never failed to remind me that God's love is always bigger, that life is priceless and beautiful, and that joy can still be found in the most painful of moments. And you also reminded me that soy sauce is not gluten-free. As we become one, I want to let you know that I, for one, am 100% committed to loving you, to laughing with you, to crying with you, to holding you, to celebrating you, and to spending a lifetime by your side. As perfectly imperfect as we are, it will always be my joy to learn from our mistakes and grow from our failures, knowing that we are in this together and that God is holding us every step of the way. It is my honor to finally be your husband. Let's do this thing called marriage.
Thank you for doing that to her. All right, Destiny, are you ready for yours?
I hope so.
There you go. Oh, whoops.
In 2018, I said yes to the call God had on my life, but little did I know what I was stepping into. Here I was, so far from home, afraid, anxious, and expectant for this new adventure, where this cowtown Colorado girl finds herself living in LA County, California. Samuel, I don't even know where to begin. Our story has been wild but beautiful. I would have never thought, only 2 weeks of living in California, I would meet the love of my life. I did not fall in love with you because I was lost and alone. I fell in love with you simply because who you are and your love for God and others. Although I claim to not have known you were going to be my husband after the first time meeting you, I always knew you would be. The peace I felt after you came into the school cafeteria and introduced yourself to me was overwhelming. I was scared at first and tried to ignore it, but man, did God overcome every doubt, fear, and insecurity, all while falling in love with you. Loving you makes me fall more in love with the Father every day. The way you have continuously pointed me closer to God through every season shows me just how much you know God solely comes first in this relationship. We have not had it easy these last couple months, but through it all, you stood firm in your faith and confident in who our God is. With our faith together, and by God's grace, we made it. There is so much ahead of us, and I know God is our foundation, and loving each other with grace, forgiveness, and patience, our love will surely prosper. Samuel, I promise to always lead you closer to the Father and remind you who you are in His eyes. I promise to continuously push you further into what He's calling you for His kingdom. I promise to put Him first and grow together in Him. I promise to laugh, cry, sit, dance, listen, worship, and pray by your side. I promise to love you with patience, grace, gentleness, kindness, and forgiveness. And maybe remember, we are on the same team. Always and forever, I love you more.
To represent the two becoming one and uniting of the family, Samuel and Destiny are going to unite the sands behind us. As the sands mix, the mixture becomes impossible to separate, as it will be with the love of Samuel and Destiny.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath.
Number 6.
All right, Samuel and Destiny have chosen to exchange rings as a symbol of the covenant that they are making today between each other and God. A ring is a powerful symbol, for as a circle, it never ends. While there may be some blemishes, ultimately, there is never a breaking point. May this be so with their marriage and their love, that there would never be a breaking point. Samuel, do you have the ring that you've chosen?
Yes.
Perfect. Then before God and man, do you take Destiny to be your wife, to have and to hold till death do you part?
I do.
Then take her hand and place the ring on her finger. And Destiny, do you have the ring that you have chosen? Then before God and man, do you take Samuel to be your husband, to have and to hold till death do you part?
I do.
Then take his hand and place a ring on his finger. Samuel and Destiny, it is with great pleasure, covered by the blood and authority of Jesus, that I now pronounce you husband and wife. May the two of you be ever in the embrace of the Father, ever in the embrace of the Son, be ever in the embrace of the Spirit, and ever in the embrace of one another. Samuel, you may kiss the bride. Yeah, yeah. Friends and family, a great journey is to come, and it is with great joy that I introduce to you the newly wedded Mr. and Mrs. Decosta. Calvin, they need to walk out music first.
No, yeah, no slideshow.
Now everybody cheer. Thank you.
faithful beyond my weakness. Your love will never change. No. Your love will never change. You won't let go. You won't let go. You won't let go. You won't let go. You won't let go of my hand. Go, won't let go of my hand. And so I will believe you're for me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. In life and in death, you have overcome. And your love will never fail.
There we go. There you go.
Hello, everyone.
Hey, guys. Thank you for joining. Love you all. We're glad you could make it virtually. I wish you could be here face-to-face, but thank you anyway for being on here. We love you guys.
We love you and hope to see you all soon. God bless you all. Bye.
Okay.
Who is that?
Everyone watching online.
Yeah. It's off now. Marco agrees. It's just not.
Okay.
I just need stage lights.
Just sign into your Spotify on here, Sam. Sam, can you sign into your Spotify on here?
Like those?
Because Dalton's running the music for the dances. And
I'll let on that.
On which computer?
I'm on this one. Yeah. I'll have that pipe in.
Oh, I'm already logged in.
Oh, you're already on it.
So it's going to be web player. And then once it loads, it's going to be this playlist right here. And to play it, you can just hit that
okay
button.
Sounds good.